Hello friends! In this video, we will discuss another smart gadget from the Tuya Smart ecosystem, the BSEED built-in socket with energy monitoring. The device is interesting because it has a modular design, which allows it to be installed in a common frame, several units at once. Energy monitoring allows you to create scenarios based on load consumption or network voltage, but there is a nuance here, which I will show in the review. In addition to the standard Tuya Smart control system, we will consider the possibility of the device working with HomeKit, Google Home, Home Assistant, and the Smart Home Center, Sonoff Ihost. Before we begin, as usual, I ask you to like this video so that more people who are interested in the topic of smart homes can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, built-in Euro socket. Control interface, Zigbee 3.0. Energy monitoring, available, power, voltage, current, energy, declared measurement error, no more than 0.2 watts, voltage range, from 100 to 240 volts, maximum load current, 16 amps, maximum power, up to 3840 watts, at a voltage of 240 volts, operating temperatures, from minus 20 to 70 degrees Celsius, ecosystem, Tuya Smart, smart life. Size, 86 by 86 by 42 millimeters. The device comes in a small cardboard box, which is universal for both sockets and switches, which, by the way, can be combined in one frame with the sockets. What exactly is in the box can be determined from a label on one side. It clearly states that it is a socket, in a European form factor, with Zigbee and energy monitoring capabilities. Everything is securely packed. The box material is sturdy, and under the lid, there is another box containing the frame, with the socket module beneath it. In addition to the socket and frame, the package includes a small manual and a pair of mounting screws. The manual explains that the socket is available in four form factors and three color options, white, black, and gold. In the review, according to this division, a white socket, German standard. As I mentioned, the device's construction is modular. The socket and the frame are separate components. The same frame can also accommodate thermostats. Additionally, there are switches, dimmers, curtain controllers, but these require their own special frames with touch buttons. There are also many uncontrolled devices and connectors for such frames, which allows them to be combined together. The external dimension of the module side, for the frame it is correspondingly internal, 47 to 48 millimeters. The external dimension of the frame side is 86 millimeters. I do not exclude that the modules may be compatible with frames from other manufacturers. Using latches, the module is first installed onto the inner metal frame, which also serves as the mounting to the wall. Then, a decorative frame is installed over it, which also holds securely on latches. To remove it, you need to pry it with something flat, but carefully, to avoid damaging the pane inside. On the inside of the socket module, there are three contacts: phase, neutral, and ground. The module itself is quite compact. This allows it to be installed even in a round junction box. However, there are two nuances here, which I will discuss. First, when installing in a row, it is necessary to consider the distance between the junction boxes, which may be less than required. Although in some reviews, they say it fits normally. The second point, the frame's fastenings do not match such a junction box, at least in my case, they could not be aligned. And it will have to be attached directly to the wall, through the frame's corner holes. With square junction boxes, there are no nuances. All holes and dimensions match perfectly. The design of the contacts is well thought out. The holes are positioned so that the wires enter from the back. And access to the screws is from above and below, which makes it more convenient to secure, especially since the wires in the junction box are often kept short to save space. Now about maintaining polarity, phase to neutral. The socket will work even if they are reversed, but in such a case, its relay will break the neutral, which is not good from an electrical safety perspective. The phase can easily be determined using a simple test screwdriver. Ground, if present, is connected to the appropriate contact. The socket can operate without it. For the test setup, I will be using a square junction box. As you can see, the size of the frame and the mounting holes matched. Here is what the installed socket looks like assembled with the frame. On the outside, there is a button that allows manually turning the socket's relay on and off. Next to it is an activity LED. Upon initial power-up, the the socket goes into pairing mode. Now, let's move on to the smart features of the hero of our review, starting with the standard control system Tuya Smart, which also works with Smart Life. As with any other device with a Zigbee interface, a gateway is needed for connection. I am using a wired version that supports HomeKit. The link to the review is in the description. The socket enters pairing mode after the first power-up. If this does not happen, press and hold the button on it until the LED starts flashing, as I just showed. The status and basic control of the socket are available from the main page of the app, but for access to full functionality, you need to go to its plugin. Most of the window here is occupied by the socket icon, under which the current relay status is written. At the bottom are four buttons, the first of which controls the power switching. Then comes a button named Timer, although in reality there are four scenario options tied to time. Countdown. This is a time interval after which the socket will change its state to the opposite. Scheduler. Allows you to create tasks for specific times and days of the week, during which the socket will either turn on or off. Circulation. An interesting mode. It works intermittently. You specify the start and end time and the duration, how long it will be on and how long off. For example, from 10 in the morning until 7 in the evening, on Thursdays and Saturdays, 5 minutes on, 10 minutes off. And the last mode, random turning on. Here, just an interval is specified during which the socket will turn on and off in a random order and duration. Energy monitoring. When a load is connected to the socket and it is powered, several parameters are displayed: current in milliamperes, power in watts, voltage in volts, and energy in kilowatt hours. Energy consumption can be viewed as a time graph. Settings menu, there are several options here. Relay activation log, if you need to track the moments of switching on and off. Power restoration behavior setting, always off, always on, default set to remember the last status. If the socket relay was on at the moment of power loss, it will turn on again when power is restored. Conversely, if the relay was off, it will remain in the same state. There is a setting for the LED indicator. It can be turned off completely or, conversely, made to stay on constantly. You can also illuminate the status. By default it is on, but if necessary, you can change it to off. If you enable the child lock, it will be displayed on the main screen of the plugin, to the right of the socket icon, and pressing the physical button will not switch the relay. The lock can be disabled from the app or by pressing the button four times in a row. In the general settings menu, which is accessed via a button at the top right of the main window, there is information about compatibility with external systems, firmware information, an option to put the plugin on the desktop, share control access, and also to remove the device from the system and delete it with all data cleared. This refers to the energy measurement. Let's see how the hero of our review can be used in automations. Like most other devices in the ecosystem, the socket can be a trigger or condition, as well as an action. In the first case, 7 option variants are available. Relay status, on or off, countdown time in seconds, greater than, less than, or equal to. Increase in consumed energy in kilowatt hours. This refers to the change relative to the current value. Value of current, power, and voltage, greater than, less than, or equal to a given condition. Values can be adjusted either by a slider or manually by entering values from the on-screen keyboard. The 7th option, triggered by errors, there are 6 of them related to 2 high or 2 low readings from the energy monitor, but the actual values are not in the plugin. I think in this case it does not work. Now about the capabilities of the socket in the automation actions section. There are only 2 options. What can be set as a result of the trigger activation? For the relay, there are 3 action options: turn on, turn off, or toggle the state to the opposite, something that many lamps and switches lack, and setting a countdown from 1 second to 12 hours. I'll show another nuance. This automation is supposed to turn off the socket's relay when the power exceeds 60 watts. The power of this bulb is over 70 watts. Turn on the socket. The energy monitor data updates and the socket turns off. But that's just at first glance. The nuance is that the automation only works when the app is open. If it is closed, the energy monitoring data does not update and the bulb remains lit. Now let's check compatibility with third-party systems. For operation in Google Home, you need to add the Tuya account credentials once through the device menu compatible with the service. After this, all supported devices will appear here automatically. The socket is supported, but only for turning on and off. There is no data on energy monitoring here. The gateway through which this socket is currently connected supports working with HomeKit. For testing, I am using one of the Home Assistant integrations, HomeKit Controller, which emulates Apple's Smart Home Hub. Although compatibility was not claimed, the socket appeared here as well. As in Google Home, only turning on and off is available. The same will be true in the Apple app. While the socket is still connected to the gateway, let's check another way of integration in Home Assistant through the Tuya integration. I should clarify, everything I have shown up to this point works simultaneously. The socket is supported by default, and besides relay control, functions such as child lock, LED control, and behavior after power restoration are available. In the sensor section, readings for current, power, and voltage were found, but they are not active by default. Therefore, you need to go into the settings of each parameter and activate them. Data updates occur within about a minute. As the socket continues to operate in the Tuya ecosystem, the issue with updating energy monitoring data is also present here. If the app is not launched, they do not update, they may show zero when a load is connected, or conversely, display the power consumed when the relay is off. This problem occurs with some relays and sockets with energy monitoring and is related not to the device itself, but to the operation of the Tuya Smart plugin. Now we will remove the socket from the gateway, which, by the way, automatically puts it into pairing mode, and continue testing compatibility. We will return to Home Assistant shortly, but for now, let's check its operation with Sonoff Ihost. I remind you, this is a local smart home control center from Ulink, something like Home Assistant, but in a very scaled-down version. However, it is very simple to use. You can find a link to its review in the description under this video. The firmware version at the time of testing is 1.13.7. The iHost has its own Zigbee coordinator, so it can directly connect devices with this interface, even from other ecosystems, which I have just done. The socket connected normally and was recognized by the system. I remind you again, iHost works locally without needing an internet connection. Control is only basic, turn on and off. There are no energy monitoring, settings for behavior after power restoration, indicators, or child locks. In the settings, there is nothing besides setting the location and use in automations. For automations, only relay statuses are available. We will return to Home Assistant, but now we will not depend on the Tuya Cloud integration, we will connect the socket directly. First, we'll check the standard ZHA integration, where I am using a DIY USB stick with SkyConnect firmware as the coordinator. You can find the link to its review as usual. Immediately after connecting, it's evident that many entities have been added to the system, which is good. Let's take a closer look. Here you have control over the socket's relay, all four energy monitoring sensors, current, power, consumed energy, and voltage. There are also additional settings for the LED, behavior after power restoration, child lock, and even firmware version checking. However, there are fewer options here. There is no option for the LED to always be on. It can either always be off or highlight one of the states. Behavior after power restoration, all options are available here. Always on, off, or resume status prior to disconnection. Naturally, all parameters update normally and quite quickly. There is no dependency on the app as in Tuya Smart. We still need to check compatibility with Zigbee 2 MQTT. The current version at the time of testing is 1.36.1 using a network coordinator Zigstar on the CC2652P2 module. The socket connected and was recognized properly. Standard support, there is no need to add external converters. Just to clarify, the socket acts as a router, meaning it can connect to other nodes of the Zigbee network and exchange data with them. The model is quite common TS011F, and it has another useful feature, which I will talk about soon. Here are all the same options we saw in the Tuya Smart app. There are even four options for the LED setting, not three like in ZHA. That the energy monitoring parameters are not displayed initially is normal. They will appear very soon, This screenshot was taken about 10 seconds after the previous one. Naturally, the energy monitoring here also updates independently. In real-time mode, I turn on the relay. Power appears. I turn it off. The power equals zero. I turn it back on. It updates again. Another nuance, power readings update much faster than current readings. So, a situation where some current value is displayed when the power is zero will be constant. But this is not a problem. Power is the key parameter. Now about why I emphasize the model of the socket. Here is its page on the Zigbee 2 MQTT website, and there are several devices from different manufacturers. The option for a software reset of consumed energy readings is available for it. Let's check if this is relevant for the hero of our review. The socket has been operating under load for some time, so that the field of consumed energy had a non-zero value. The exact figure doesn't matter. We need the developer console tab. It is the furthest to the right, located in the same place, in the device properties, where I showed the tabs with information and the list of exposures. Here we need to select the first endpoint, cluster 0x00, and command 0, then press the execute button. If you need more details, I have also left a link to a video about this in the description. After executing this command, let's check the result. An important point, although the energy value is actually reset, the display of readings changes at the moment of the next update. For me, this happened almost immediately. The reset option works, however, it is currently manual, and how to automate this is still unknown to me. While I have encountered similar sockets, most often they are in the form of overlays, adapters. Built-in ones are much fewer and not all have a modular design. This can be called the main feature of this model. For users of the Tuya Smart system, it is necessary to consider the nuance related to the energy monitoring data update, which occurs only when the application is open. When used with alternative coordinators, this problem does not exist. Everything updates correctly and fairly quickly. During the testing period, no failures or problems were noticed. So far, the impressions are favorable. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes, they help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and lessons, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find many useful links to stores where you can order this socket, to the mentioned reviews and lessons, and other resources of mine, a Telegram channel, a Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until we meet again, peace to all.